Class 5 IMO Level 2 Mathematics. Mathematics question number 31. A kettle holds 1 liter 625 ml of tea. If a small cup of 125 ml capacity is used to serve, then for how many people the tea can be served? In order to find, we have to divide the capacity of the tea kettle to the capacity of 1 teacup. Then we will get 13 teacups. Therefore, one kettle of capacity 1 liter 625 ml can serve 13 people. Mathematics question number 32. The given photograph shows the number of donuts sold by a shopkeeper during 5 days of a week. Study the graph carefully and answer the following questions. On which 2 days the same number of donuts were sold? As we can see, Monday and Friday have the same day because both of them have 50 donuts. Second question. If cost of each donut is 15 rupees, then find the total amount of money earned by the shopkeeper in all 5 days. If cost of each donut is 15 rupees, then find the total amount of money earned by the shopkeeper in all 5 days. One donut is equal to 15 rupees. So we're going to calculate how many donuts of each day and then we're going to multiply it by 15. We have to add to find the total amount of money earned by him in all 5 days. If we add, we'll get 3300. Mathematics question number 34. Which of the following pairs of lines represent the line of symmetry for the given figure? Here in this figure, A, B and EF represent the line of symmetry. Mathematics question number 35. Sneha has 5 red ribbons and 8 pink ribbons. Each red ribbon is length 204 cm and total length of the ribbon Sneha has is 22 meter 84 cm. What is the length of each pink ribbon? Length of one red ribbon is equal to 204 cm. So in order to find 5 red ribbons, we have to multiply 204 into 5, which is equal to 1020 cm. Total length of ribbon Sneha had is equal to 2284 cm. Length of 5 red ribbon is equal to 1020 cm. In order to find 8 pink ribbons, we have to subtract the total from the 5 red ribbons. The length of 8 pink ribbon is equal to 1264. In order to find length of 1 pink ribbon, we have to divide the length of 8 pink ribbons by 8, which is equal to 158 cm. Mathematics question number 36. Select the correct match. A is wrong because the Roman number given is actually 945. B is correct. C is also wrong. So our answer is B. Mathematics question number 37. How many letters of the given word has exactly one line of symmetry? Here the letters with exactly one line of symmetry are M, D, A and Y. So the answer is 4. Mathematics question number 38. How many right angles are there in the given figure? There are 3 right angles in the given figure. Mathematics question number 39. Which of the following options shows the common multiples of 5 and 15? The common multiples of 5 and 15 are 15, 30, 45 and 60. That shows B. Mathematics question number 40. A fruit seller has 69,875 apples. He has to pack them in a box, with each box containing 325 apples. Find the number of boxes required to pack all the apples. So the total number of apples fruit seller has is equal to 69,875. One box contains 325 apples. So number of box required to pack the apples is equal to total divided by number of apples in one box, which is equal to 215. Mathematics question number 41. Select the incorrect option. A. An angle greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree is an acute angle. Wrong. An angle greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree is an obtuse angle. B. A square has 3 pairs of perpendicular lines. This is also wrong because squares have 4 perpendicular lines. C. The smaller angle made by the hands of a clock at 3 o'clock is an obtuse angle. Wrong. 3 o'clock the hands make right angle. So the answer is all of these. Mathematics question number 42. Find the sum of the numbers when each number is rounded off to the nearest thousand. When we round off, we get 1,55,000 and 4,05,000. And when we add, we will get 5,60,000. So our answer is C. Mathematics question number 43. The given table shows the prices of three types of eggs. 1/4 of the eggs Priyanka bought were chicken eggs. 1/8 of them were century eggs and the rest were quail eggs. If she spent the total of 6.50 rupees on the chicken eggs and century eggs, then how much did she spend on the quail eggs? Given 1/4 of the eggs is chicken eggs. So we can write it as 2/8, equivalent fraction of 1/4. Given 1/8 of eggs is century eggs. So 2/8 of them are chicken eggs, 1/8 is century eggs, and the rest are quail eggs. So the remaining part, 5/8, she bought is quail eggs. We don't know the total eggs. Let's assume the total eggs to be TE. She spent 6.50 for chicken eggs and century eggs. We can write it as number of chicken eggs into cost of one chicken egg, which is equal to 2/8 into TE into 20, which is equal to 40/8 TE. And number of century eggs into cost of one century egg, which is equal to 1/8 into TE into 90, which is equal to 90/8 TE. Given 40/8 TE plus 90/8 TE is equal to 650 pairs. So from this we can get TE is equal to 40. So total eggs, which is equal to 40 eggs. From this we can get the number of quail eggs she bought and costs of it. Number of quail eggs is equal to 5/8 into 40, which is equal to 25 eggs. Cost of 25 quail eggs is equal to 25 into 5 pairs, which is equal to 125 pairs, which is equal to 1 rupee and 25 pairs. Mathematics question number 44. The difference between 4 tenths, 12 tenths, 25 hundredths and 3 tenths, 14 tenths, 45 thousandths is 10.005. Mathematics question number 45. Mr. Gupta and his family started watching a movie at 8:30 hours. The movie lasted for 2 hours 35 minutes and they reached home at 13:20 hours. How long did it take for them to reach home? Mr. Gupta and his family started watching a movie at 8:30 hours. The ending time of the movie is equal to 8:30 plus 2 hours 35 minutes. That is the duration of the movie, which is equal to 11:05. Time taken to reach home is equal to 13:20 minus 11:05, which is equal to 2 hours 15 minutes. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.